Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will be learning in detail about how to swap two numbers in C programming. So if you are new to this channel, please subscribe my channel and also watch my previous uploads. So without any delay, let's get started. Swapping two numbers. We all know very well that swapping of two numbers means to interchange the value of two variables. This can be performed mainly by two processes. One with temporary variable method and the other without temporary variable method. In this video, I'll be mostly talking about the second method. And if you would like to learn about the first method, that is with temporary variable method, then I have recently made a video on it and I have provided the link on the description. Now the second method can be further divided into three subcategories. They are using addition, subtraction method, using product division method and using bitwise operator or XOR operator. Before talking about these methods, let us consider two variables x and y, whose initial values before swapping are 6 and 7 respectively. And after swapping, the values will interchange, that is x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. Now let's talk about the first method, addition subtraction method. We have x equals to 6 and y equals to 7. In this method, we add these two values and the sum is subtracted with the values of these two numbers, that is 6 and 7. One after another. When we add x and y, the sum is 13. When we subtract the sum with the value of x, we get 7, which is the value of y. Similarly, when we subtract the sum with the value of y, what do we get? We get 6, the value of x. Let me make you more clear about this. Here we have again, x equals to 6 and y equals to 7. We add x and y and store the value in x. This implies x equals to 13 and y equals to 7. Furthermore, we again subtract the new value of x from the old value of y and store the result in y. This will result y equals to 6 and x equals to 13. Again, we subtract x and y, but this time we store the value in x. This implies x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. So finally, our output is x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. Comparing the before and after, we have successfully interchanged the values of x and y. Before coding this method, I also want to talk about the next method, which is product and division method. These both methods are similar. Here we have x equals to 6 and y equals to 7. This process comprises of one multiplication and two division. In this method, we replace the addition with multiplication and subtraction with division. Looks similar, isn't it? So the two numbers are at first multiplied and the product is then divided by one of the value. Let's first do for x. Now 42 divided by 6 is 7. Now this is the value of y. Now again we divide the product with the other value. This will give us 6, which is the value of x. Here we have x equals to 6 and y equals to 7. Now first of all, x and y are multiplied and the result is stored in x. This implies x equals to 42 and y equals to 7. Here the value of y is not changed. The second step we do is we divide the x with y and store the result in y. This implies y equals to 6 and x equals to 42. Again we divide x by y and this time store the value in x. This will result in x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. Now again we obtain x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. When we compare both these values before swapping and after swapping, these are interchanged. Now let's code these two processes. I have already written program for you. Here's for the first process and here's for second process. Now these are the header files and here starts our the main body. Now first of all, we initialize two variables A and B. Now we ask their value from the user. Now we write the code which we discussed earlier. So let's see the output. So we provide value of A as 4 and value of B as 6. So as the method suggests, these values must be interchanged. So our output must be A equals to 6 and B equals to 4. So to see the output, let's press enter. We got what we wanted. Similarly, let's look for the second method. Unlike process 1, I have initialized two variables A and B and asked their value from the user and written some formulas which we had discussed earlier in this video. So let's see the output. This time I will enter the value for A 14 and B 16. So what we want the output? The output must be A equals to 16 and B equals to 14. So to see the output, press enter. And the output is A equals to 16 and B equals to 14. This was what we wanted. So we have successfully swapped two numbers using two methods. One using addition, subtraction and other product division. Now the third method, using bitwise operator, or we can also say XOR operator. Before talking about this topic, let's get clear about bitwise operator. Bitwise operator converts the decimal into binary and then performs bitwise operation. The bitwise operation of XOR operator can be summarized in the shown table. The table clearly states that when we have like bits, then the output is 0, and when we have unlike bits, the output is 1. So let's jump towards the method. We have x equals to 6, whose binary value is x equals to 110. Similarly, y equals to 7, its corresponding binary value is 111. Here we have x equals to 110 and y equals to 111. Now first of all, we XOR these two values. You can see the calculation on the screen. The output is 001. Now the obtained result is again XORed with the Y. Similarly, the value is again 110. Again, the obtained value is the value of X. Now these two values are again XORed. Then what do we get? We get 111. Now this 111 is the value of Y. This process is a bit tricky. So let's make it more convenient. We have X equals to 6 and Y equals to 7. The corresponding binary values of these two variables are 110 and 111. Respectively. First of all, we XOR X and Y and store the value in X. This implies X equals to 001 and Y equals to 111, which is unchanged. Now again, we XOR X and Y, but this time we store the value in Y. This implies Y equals to 110 and X equals to 001. Similarly, once again we XOR X and Y and store the value in X. This results in X equals to 111 and Y equals to 110. Our final answer is X equals to 111 and y equals to 110. When we convert these two values in decimal, we get x equals to 7 and y equals to 6. And here also, we get the interchanged value of x and y. Now let's see the program for bitwise operator. As earlier, I have already written the program. So in this program, I have initialized two variables a and b as I had done before. And I have asked input from the user. And these are the formulas which we discussed. This complete program is for swapping two numbers. So let's compile and check whether this program interchanges the values or not. So this time we give A equals to 8 and B equals to 9. And the output is A equals to 9 and B equals to 8. These are the interchanged values. So we have successfully swapped the values of two variables A and B. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked this video, please hit the like button and subscribe for more updates.